this particular thing, if I show you the diagram, what we are doing. We are studying create join relationship between queries. Okay. So let's say there is one query and there is another query. If we merge them, we can generate.
Yes, sir. I had doubt in this. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Your name?
Sir Shubham.
Shubham, huh? So this is called the joining the queries. Okay. So that we will be learning now. And this you will be finding in course 2 guide. Okay. Create reports based on query relationship. So how to do that? Go to page number 59. This we are going to do. Muting you, are you? So how to do that? First, home, then click new. Okay. In new, click report. This is neither tough, not very easy. Okay. Instead of blank active report, now we will be clicking the blank. Click OK. Select source, the same. Samples. Double click. Data. Double click. Sample data module. Open. So this is very new thing actually today we are going to learn. Here you need to click report. Okay. If you click, you'll find some queries. So I'm clicking the queries. So this is the very new page you are seeing the very first time. So we will be creating two queries and then we will be joining those two queries. Okay. First query. This is by default query 1, second query, and third query. Okay. Now we will be joining this query 2 and query 3, and after connecting these two, we will be connecting to query number 1. So how to do that? Click join. Select the query 1 and then double click the join. Then shift this query 2 to here, and this query 3 to here. So the complete thing has not moved, the shortcut has been moved. So whatever we will be doing here, this will be reflecting here. Now double click the query 2. So here we need to mention some data. Read the PDF. Create a new blank, this we have done on the query side, this we have done toolbox, that we have done. From toolbox query, this we have done. So now we are working on task 2. Add data to queries. So in the work area, double click query 2, that we have done. Not the linked shortcut. We should not link, we should not click this one. Sorry, this query 3 will. So we will not be clicking this, rather we will be clicking this. So double click this, so this page will be open. Now we'll put some data. So from where we get the data, instead of toolbox, we should go to the sources. Then 3. Okay, so which data to be taken? Product, sorry, order number and data, sorry, sales order, order number. So first we'll take the order number. So if you see the data set, we don't have the order number, rather we are having the product number. So what we will be doing, we will be double clicking the product number. So by default, this will come here. Okay. Double click. So by default, this will come here. Now we need to shift the product here. So how to do that? Drag it instead of double clicking. Because if you double click it, it will come here. Okay. So this is the query, one of the query. So just mention equals to question mark, name would be product. Again question mark. Okay. Why I'm doing this? Because read this one. From the sales order query subject, drag order number to the data items pane that we have done. You want this query to include only order that contain a specific product selected at a runtime. From the products query subject, drag product to the detailed filters. We have dragged it. Create and validate the following filter expression. So this is by default. Sales query dot products dot product equals to question mark product and question mark. So we did the same thing. With the sample data module, sample file go sales product equals to question mark product question mark. So in last practical, we understood this validate. Just click this. So it will be validated. So it has been validated. Okay. No error has been mentioned. Now click OK to close the detailed filter expression. So this is called the detailed filter expression. See, detailed filter expression. Click OK. So this has been done. Now we need to name. If you remember, this is the query 2. So we need to name it. How to do that? On the application bar, click Show Property to open the properties pane. With the product detail filter selected, the properties pane under the general section, change application property to after auto aggregation. So instead of before auto aggregation, we should be clicking after auto aggregation. We did that. Now, on the queries inside pane, click query 2 so that we can name it. And what should be the name? Order number by product. How to do that? Click query 2. Where is the query 2? Here. Query 2. Now here we need to mention the name. What should be the name? Order number by product. So write it. Order number by product. You will add data to query 3. Now we will be adding data to query 3. So on the queries, click query 3. So what we'll be doing? Click here. Go to query 3. This is query 3. So this is blank. This is query 3. If you read this. Now we'll be adding some data. What data is required? Order number, date, product, quantity, revenue. 5 things. So first we will start with the order number. As we know, order number is not there. So we will be clicking the product number. First product number. Then date and product. So instead of date, we are having the year. Okay. Then product and quantity and revenue. Product. Quantity and revenue. Done. Now click query 3 and we should name product quantity and revenue. Product quantity. Yeah. Product. On the queries, click query 3. This we have done. On the queries, click queries folder. So now we will be going to queries folder. This is the queries folder. If you remember, we have renamed the query number 2 and we have renamed the query number 3. You can see the number name, order number by product, and this is product quantity and revenue. So when we will be merging both, both data should be reflected in the query one. Okay. Now, this we have done. Task 3. Create a joint relationship between the two named. How to join it? We need to join these two. How to join this? Just double click. This has opened. Create the new link. Click the new link. I've clicked it. But this product number and product number should match. So that's why I'll be shifting this. Okay. So this should take some time to connect it. This takes some extra effort actually. So by this way, this comes, okay, and then join relationship that we have done, answer order number by product. Okay, both should be there. Then this we have already done, right? Is one end. This is one end. So this is by default. There's no need to think much on it. Okay, go ahead. Click OK to close the join relationship. So click OK. So we have clicked it. Click OK to join relationship dialog box, and then on the queries click query number 1. Again we need to click query number 1. How to do that? Report, this is query number 1. Now from the data, which data to be taken? Product quantity and revenue. Okay. Product quantity and revenue. So go to data. This is product quantity and revenue. Just drag it. Done. And what should be the name? Select product quantity and revenue by order number. Select product quantity. How to rename it? Select product quantity. Select product quantity and revenue by order number. And revenue. Order number. Very big name. Now what to do? From the data or data items tab, in the data items pane, click product, and then on the properties pane, change the pre-sort property to sort ascending. Let's see whether this sort ascending is there. No. So we need to go to data or data items tab, where we can find it. Data or data items tab. This is the data items tab. In the data items pane, data items pane is not visible. So click product and then properties pane. From the data or data items tab, this we are working on query number one. Okay. So this we have done, rename the query as this one. Then from the data items tab, in the data items pane, data items tab, data items pane.
सर वो डेटा आइटम्स में प्रोडक्ट में वो क्वेरी हिंट में ऑटो सॉर्ट की जगह प्री सॉर्ट हो जाएगा
या बट वेयर आई एम नॉट एबल टू फाइंड एक्चुअली
सर पहले प्रोडक्ट पे क्लिक करने के बाद डेटा आइटम्स पैन में फिर ऑटो सॉर्ट पे क्लिक करके देखिए उधर ही आता है यहां पे
ग्रेट ग्रेट ओके सो व्हाट इट इज सेइंग इन द डेटा आइटम्स व्हेन वी क्लिक प्रोडक्ट प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड दिस सेंटेंस दिस डेटा एंड डेटा आइटम्स टैब. So this is actually the data or data items tab. Then it is saying click product. So we have clicked the product as I think Gauri said.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, great. So the same thing, whatever we are learning, but we were not getting. So Gauri got. So in data item tab, click product and then in properties pane. So when we click this product, this option changed. Then instead of pre-sorting, don't sort, we need to click the sort ascending. Okay. Thank you, Gauri. So this is sort ascending. Now we need to go to task 4, add data to the list and then run the report. So actually we have done everything. Now we need to just add the data to the list and how to do that. This is also very easy. Instead of clicking the list, we need to just shift it or double click it. Then run the report. Okay. So how to do that? On the pages in the site pane, click page number one. So I hope you have understood till now. In report, when you click this, you will go to page number one. And then in page number one, if you go to query, we need to shift this one. Okay. So which one to be shifted? Select product quantity and revenue by order number. So this is select product quantity and revenue by order number. You just drag it. Automatically this will become one list, and please understand the series of it. Okay, how to do that? This should be the series: order number, date and product. Whether we do have this one? No, order number. So we'll be selecting this one and we'll be moving to this. How to do that? Just select it and move to the leftmost. So product number is here, then date, that is year. Select this year, move it to year we found. After that, product. So product will be here. Okay, next is quantity and revenue. Now select the quantity. Actually, click the quantity. Sorry, before that, this one. Order number and date should be group and ungroup. This order number and date. Year. Control year, just group and ungroup. So this is the group and ungroup. I'll just click. Then go to quantity. What is the way actually? Click the quantity and list column body. One by one we need to do. This is the quantity. This one. List column body. Click this one. And then go to summary and total. So likewise, select the revenue. List column body. And then summary total. Okay. Now we are ready to run it. Okay. So we did this also, click the revenue, list column body, and then summarize, click total. run the report in HTML. So actually we are done. Just run it, run HTML, and we'll get the result. So this will be the output. This is simple output actually, and you know this is the report, and this is order number and date, the product quantity revenue. The only thing is that this is important to be understood. This one. First we selected the order number, this is one query. Then we selected the product quantity and revenue, that is another query. And then we connected this, and then this is the output. Okay, query one, which is the merged version of this one and this one, or the joint version of this one and this one. Okay, let us see our output. So actually, this is, as I told you, this is not very easy, neither very tough. I cannot mention it as tough because it expects the practice. If you do first time, it may seem tough, but if you do fourth or fifth time, it will be easy. The only thing that I didn't find sufficient time for the last step. Otherwise, this is not very tough. And this may come in the exam. This is very important for the examination purpose. And you have to write the theory part of it. Okay. Now, if I click any particular product. Product. This is the list of the product. So let's say one product, Aloe Relief, and then click OK. So this is the output. Okay. Now likewise, you can run again and you can see the output. So what I will be doing, I will be opening the session for the query. You ask me the question where you found any problem. Then if you wish, I can run it again. And then I will allow you to run your own program, and then I'm expecting the output in the